Hello everyone. Today I want to introduce you to Keenious. Keenious analyzes written text and then suggests potential academic sources that may be relevant. It sources these suggestions from OpenAlex, a comprehensive catalog of over 240 million works of open and non-open access journals. It is important to note here that Stellenbosch University may not have access to all the articles that Keenious recommends. But remember that if you cannot access a specific article or book, you can always request that item via our interlibrary loan service. Now, Keenious works with Microsoft Word, with Google Docs, and with PDF documents. But today I'm going to demonstrate how it works as a plugin in Microsoft Word. To do that, I first generated some text in ChatGPT. The topic I chose was water desalination plants. So I'm going to copy that text and paste it in a blank document. Then, in the top, you'll see I already have the Keenious plugin installed. So I click on that and I'll wait for it to load. Then you have your two options. It prompts you to either explore using text or explore using a PDF. In this instance, I'm going to explore using the text that I have pasted. And here I get the first set of results. In order to get access to the more than 2,000 results that are available, I first have to sign in. I have already created an account, so I am just going to sign in now. And then I go back to the pasted document. Now I get an overview of all the relevant results. You can choose how many results you want to see at one go, and Keenious has additional benefits. It tells you how many citations a specific article has had. For instance, the environmental impact of desalination technologies, a review, has already had 165 citations, which means that it is a well-read and well-referenced article. Let's find out more about this specific article. If you click on it, here you get more information. You get the authors, you get the journal title, and you get the abstract. You can even expand the abstract to get it in full. And you get topics and similar articles as well. To access the full item, let's try it and see what happens. Unfortunately, it will always take you to LibKey, which Stellenbosch University is not affiliated with. So we will have to approach this a bit differently. Highlight the title, copy it, and then in Google Scholar, you can conduct a search to find the article. And here we see we have the information. If you are working from home and you do not get this link that says full text at Stellenbosch, there is something very important that you need to do. You need to go to these little burger bars to the left of the Google Scholar slide. Click on it and then click on Settings. Then click on Library Links and then search for Stellenbosch. I'm already connected, so it already appears. But for you, it will appear as a new option that you can tick. So you tick it and then save. Then, whenever an article is available via Stellenbosch University, you will now be notified. Again, if you are viewing this from home, you will first have to go through our easy proxy system to verify your credentials. In my case, I was able to go directly since I'm recording from my office. And as you can see, we do have access to this article. And there you have it. And so it goes on. Now you can ask Keenious to analyze this PDF and get even more relevant information. So, if you are interested in Keenious, but you're unsure how to install it in MS Word or how to take it further from here, you are welcome to contact me. My details will be available in this blog post. And that's it. I hope you found this interesting and that you will find Keenious useful in your studies.